today, I want to present one exercise which is very important for us. Okay. So, my name is Bah Celeste. I want to solve the simple exercise. Okay. This exercise is about first number. I will read the exercise and then I will solve it. Let A and B be two fuzzy numbers whose membership is given by this formula. This A of X means for each interval, okay, we have given these expressions. You have A and then you have B. Okay? You see B properly? This A of X is B of X. So we want to calculate A plus B and A minus B. This is the aim of the exercise. Given two fuzzy numbers, okay, we want to calculate A and B. So I will solve. Very simple. So, first of all, we have to define what is a fuzzy set. Okay. So, alpha cut of A, it is the set of X, side delta, A of X, is bigger than delta. Okay. And now, alpha cut of B, equal to the set of X, side delta, B of X, is bigger than alpha. Okay, so our aim is to calculate. Our aim is to calculate A plus B and A minus B of X. The first step, we will determine the calculator, the alpha cut of A plus B. The alpha cut of A minus B. Yes, because we have already defined what is alpha cut of A. Alpha cut of A is a set of X, side delta A of X is greater than or equal to alpha. B then, so first we determine alpha cut of A. Okay, so given this expression, look at given this expression, we will determine alpha cut of A. Okay, so alpha cut of A. Okay, alpha cut of A. I'm going to do for the lower bound. For the lower bound of the interval, we have x plus 2 out of 2 equal to alpha. That means that x equal to alpha. Okay. And the upper bound of the interval. Okay, upper bound. We have 2 minus x divided by 2. X. 2 minus x divided by 2 equal to alpha. That implies that 2 minus x equal to 2 alpha. And minus x equal to 2 alpha. Minus 2. That implies that x equal to minus 2 alpha plus 2. Okay, so demanding x1 and x2, which are respectively the lower bound and the upper bound of our interval, that means alpha cut of A equal to B, 2 alpha minus 2 and minus 2 alpha plus 2. Okay. So you have alpha cut of A. Using the same principle, you will determine alpha cut of B. Using the expression of B of S, you will determine now the alpha cut of B. Do you understand? We determine now alpha cut of B. Alpha cut of B. So using the same process, okay, for the lower bound, x minus 2 equal to alpha, that implies that x equal to upper bound, we have 6 minus 6 minus x divided by 2 equal to alpha, that implies that minus x God do? Today I come to tell you that what is yes, to God do? Two alpha minus six. That implies x to God do minus alpha plus six. So, brackets of B, you will take respectively the lower bound and the upper bound of the integral. So, together, 2 alpha plus 2 and minus 2 alpha plus 6. Okay. So, we have respectively, you can mean. Okay. Alpha cut of A and alpha cut of B. So, if now we should determine alpha cut of A plus B, we will apply the formula. It's very simple. If you have 2 alpha cuts, there is one formula we apply, it's very simple. Alpha cut of A, for example, it is A, B. Alpha cut of B, for example, it is C, D. That is that alpha cut of A plus alpha cut of B. That is called alpha cut of A plus B. Okay. This is A plus C. A plus C, and now?
B plus D.
Is that it? So using this formula, you will now determine alpha cut of A plus B equal to this one plus this one. Is that it? So you do 2 alpha minus 2 plus 2 alpha plus 2 and minus 2 alpha plus 2 minus 2 alpha plus 6. So we are going to get here B 4 alpha and then on minus 4 alpha minus 4 alpha
plus 8
plus 8. So minus 2 alpha 2 alpha plus 2 alpha is 4 alpha minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Then minus 2 alpha minus 4 alpha 2 plus 6 is plus 8. Okay. Then we determine alpha cut of A minus B. Alpha cut of A minus B is this one minus this one. So we get 2 alpha minus 2 minus this one plus 2 alpha minus 6 and minus 2 alpha plus 2 minus 2 alpha minus 2. So we will get the result. The final result will be 4 alpha. 4 alpha minus 8 and minus 4 alpha. Okay. 4 alpha minus 8 minus 4 alpha. Then after determining alpha cut of A plus B and alpha cut of A minus B. Now determine up. Calculate down. Calculate. For instance, over A plus B. Okay. A plus B of X. It's very simple. What I want to do means for each interval, we determine the value of A plus B. Okay. So, what is the value and the interval? That's how we determine the bounding interval. Means the interval on which we represent our A plus B. So, we bound it up. The body and the body is the mean when alpha equal to 0. Okay, for it is alpha equal to 0. Okay, alpha equal to 0 for alpha cut. In this case, we have alpha cut of A plus B. Here, if alpha equal to 0, it will be 0 and 8. 4 into 0 is 0. Then we have that by that. Our interval here, because it is 0. 0, 8. Okay. So this is the first bounding interval. Means our representation will be done on 0, on the interval 0, 8. Okay. So that means A plus B of X equal to 0 for X less than 0 and
8.
Greater than 0. This is the first case. The second case, we are going to do. Okay, we will determine A plus B of X. For each expression of the interval. So for the lower bound, we have what? 4 alpha equal to x, that implies that alpha equal to x
by 4.
Divided by 4. But alpha must be equal to 1 here. So when alpha equal to 1, x equal to 4.
4.
When alpha equal to 1, then x equal to 4. That means a plus b of x equal to x divided by 4. 4. Okay. 0 less than x less than equal to 4. After that, for the upper bound, we get minus 4 alpha plus 8 equal to x. That implies that minus 4 alpha. Yes, minus 4 plus 8. Yes. Minus 4 alpha equal to x minus 8. That implies that alpha equal to minus x plus 8 divided by 4. Okay. For less than x less than or equal to 8. So our conclusion of a plus b of x. So a plus b of x equal to 0 for x less than 0 and x greater than 8, x by 4, and minus x plus 8 by 4 for x 0, 4, then x equal to 8. So you use the same process to determine a minus b of x.
So
you have any question? Some questions?
No, thank you.
Okay. You don't have any questions. It's clear.
So
yeah, come on, you ask your question. Use the same process.
What is your name? First of all.
So my question is, can we make the graph by using these balloons?
Tell me something. Why we
My question is that can we make the graph by using this balloon?
Yeah, you can make the graph. It's very simple. Okay, just because this one is an expression of a fuzzy set. Okay, so this is a function. So each function has its implementation. If you want, you can invent it with the term. But you can invent it. It's very simple to invent this one. You can invent it.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. You're welcome.
Hope guys, you all understand whatever Bah have taught to you. I hope you will enjoy this. Thank you very much. Keep watching.